YouTubers. This is my teddy bear hamster. He is one and a half year old, and he is not turtle, and he loves to eat, and they love to run. As you can see, well, and they're very curious. He is very cute, and he is very cuddly, and he loves to be held. He loves to be pet. Don't you, Juju? And they eat a pretty good bit. That's why he's fat. For him, he's really fat. He's a fat hamster. I treat him good. Is that right, Juju? And I'm going to talk about his diet. I'm going to talk about his food. Well, his cage, which you should put in there. Well, this is his cage. I am about to clean it out and put him inside his little ball. As you can see, he needs a water bottle. He needs a food bowl. He needs a wheel to exercise. And they love to burrow where they can sleep. And they know they're not going to be hurt or anything or attacked. And we're about to clean his cage out. I will demonstrate how do you clean the cage out. So I'll put him inside his little ball. This is his. He is a boy. Even I got him purple because I thought it was cute. And I have a little pink ball. But today we're going to be using the purple ball. Well, I think today we're going to use the pink ball because the purple ball is a little dirty. So. This is how you open the top, take the top off, you get the hamster, and you put him inside the ball. This is how they get good exercise. And then put them on the floor, make sure they have a wide area to run around in. As you can see, they do run a pretty good bit. And this, I'm gonna show you how to clean the cage out. Step number one, first of all, you want to take all the stuff out. All his food and stuff out. Step number two, second step, what you want to do is you want to dump the bedding. What you want to do is you want to do this. And make sure you get all that bedding. There might be little spots in there that we can clean out. So, you want to make sure, you see where the little black dabs are? You want to make sure there is no more bedding on there so he can get sick or anything. And that is basically how you dump his bedding out. So, to step number three. All right, step number three. What you want to do is you want to get some type of shampoo or something. Well, I'm using this for example. What you want to do is you want to pour just a tad little bit in there. As you can see, you don't want to pour that much. It could cause the hamster to get sick. So then what you want to do is you want to put it under the water. What you want to do is you want it to fill up the dip cell. So get all the water with them. You want to put warm water in there so it'll make it where it will come off easier instead of cold water. So we have to wait till it fills up. So as you can see that it is filling up. So then what you want to do is you want to turn the water off. You want to get a rag. And then what you want to do is get a better rag. What you want to do is you want to, inside of it, you want the soap. Wash the soap some. Make it get all bubbly. Scratch the side, do the sides of it so it'll come off easier. It'll make it where it'll come off easier. So that's what we're planning to do. See, as I'm wiping it, the bedding is coming unloose, and it is
making it easier to clean when it is hot. Then what you want to do is you want to do the cage, and then you want to cup it. And then there may be still a little bit in there, but not much. It makes it a little bit cleaner. So all to step number four to do is you want to dry it so the hamster will not get a disease. The disease is called wet tail. Be sure not to bathe your hamsters. Do not put it in any type of water. It could cause them to have the disease, wet tail. So now what you want to do is you want to get paper towels or something. And then you see how it's all wet? What you want to do is you want to roll off some. Then you want to dry your cage so your hamster will not get sick. You want to make sure you make it nice and dry. There may be a little tad wetness in there, but it will not hurt them. Make sure you want to get the outside of it too. And just remember, you don't have to use a glass cage. I just prefer it because my hamster, he is very smart. I'd prefer you to get a glass cage though. The bars, he chews one side of it and then he chews the other and he just rips the bar off and acts like it's a gel cell. So that's why I use glass cage. It makes it more secure. And the cage costs more than the glass cage. That's why I got this too. As you can see, it still may be a little tad wet, but it won't hurt that much. Make sure you want to get as most as you can though. Because they still could get sick. Make it healthy for your animal to live. Okay. Also, step number four. Sorry, I meant step number five. What you want to do now is you want to put a little bit of bedding in there. Not much, but a pretty good bit to make it cozy for your hamster. I don't really prefer this, but I mean, you can if you want. But I would rather use the comfy soft bedding instead of the pine bedding. That's what we're going to be using today, though. The comfy bedding makes it easier for your hamster to live. It makes it more soft for your hamster. It makes it more comfy for your hamster, so that's why I really prefer the comfy bedding. But today we're going to be using... Today we're going to be using the pine bedding. So, here we go. There, as you can see, I have finished. Make it where it'll be about that big, that much for your hamster. You don't need that much bedding in there because it'll cost more money if you put a lot of bedding in there. I've learned the hard way. On the step number six, what you want to do is you want to go ahead. Always you want to check your hamster and make sure he is still secure in his ball. Alright. What you want to do now is you want to get the toys and you want to put it back to his cage. So here we go.